The man whose job it was to stop such intrusions was the police chief of eastern Croatia, Josip Reihl-Kir. He commanded 1,000 armed men, Croatia's only military force there. But Kir refused to take the path of confrontation. He did all he could to make sure Serbs and Croats went on living together.
Redovno sam se viđao sa Josipom. Gde god bi Srbi postavili barikadu, Reihl-Kir bi odlazio tamo autom, uvek nenaoružan, izlazio bi, otvarao bi sako i govorio. Nenaoružan sam, ubeđivao ih i u najvećem broju slučajeva bi uspio da ih ubedi odmah da tu barikadu uklone.
But the police chief had an opponent in the local party leader. The nationalist wing in Croatia's ruling party was as extreme as any in Serbia.
Došla delegacija iz Zagreba, koji je bio prisutan i glavaš, i zatražili od njega da ih odvede u Borovo selo.
Borovo selo is a suburb of Vukovar, the main city on Croatia's bank of the Danube. It was a prime target for the Serb nationalists. In the center, the population was a mix of Croats and Serbs. But the suburb was mostly Serb, and the extremists set up barricades to keep Croats out.
On ih je tamo odveo, izašao iz auta, magla je bila. Otvorili su prtežnik, izvadili iz prtežnika ambrustere. Josip je samo gledao zbunjeno i ispalio 3 granate pravcu Borova sela. Prva granata je pogodila tanjuraču, tu barikadu nazovimo. Druga je otišla u kukuruzište, a treća u zid prve kuće u selu.
This act of provocation was committed by some of President Tudjman's closest political partners. Other members of his cabinet soon found out.
Kir je posle svega toga došao kod mene i rekao mi. U grupi za Borovo selo bio je gospodin Susak, sadašnji ministar obrane, bio je Vice Vukojević, tada pomoćnik ministra unutrašnjih poslova.
Susak, recently returned from exile in Canada, was leader of the party's extreme wing. His midnight rocket attack did not cow his Serb victims in Vukovar. They turned to Belgrade for protection.
Borovo selo je tražilo da jedan broj naših dobrovoljaca tamo postavimo da budu u stalnom obezbeđenju. Oružje smo dobijali od Miloševićeve policije.
The Serbs in the Vukovar suburb seized 2 Croat policemen. The Croats hit back.
Došli su svojim autobusima u centar sela, Hrvati.
2 buses of heavily armed Croat police drove confidently into the Serb stronghold, straight into an ambush.
I bilo je dakle kritično ti prvi pola sata otpora koji su pružili naši dobrovoljci, dok se celo selo diglo na oružje i onda su Hrvati bitku izgubili.
12 Croat policemen were killed, 22 wounded. That night, Croatia exploded with fury. Crowds burned the Yugoslav flags they saw as a symbol of Serbia.
Što se tiče situacije u kojoj smo našli, Ministarstvo unutrašnjih poslova naredit će mobilizaciju rezervnog sastava u kriznim područjima. Mi ćemo znati obraniti svaki pedalj hrvatske zemlje.
As Croatia and Serbia slid towards war, the extremists took charge. The war party close to President Tudjman were determined to put an end to the peacekeeping of their own police chief, Reihl-Kir. They set out to get rid of him.
Bio je u Zagrebu kod svog ministra Boljkovca i rekao mu da nema više kuda, da je gotov.
Onda mi je između oslog rekao: ministre, pomognite mi, ja ću biti ubijen, povucite me u Zagreb. Ja ću raditi sve. Rekao: Kir, pa nemojte biti dijete, popili smo viski, pa neće biti tako. Ja vas molim, spašavajte me. I na to dođe k meni: a ko će vas? Pa veli: slušajte, on je spomenuo Glavaša, Vukojevića, i spomenuli u Zagrebu vrh koji je bio ministar Suška i ovih, jel?
The police minister agreed to transfer Chief Kier to the capital, but on the day he was to leave, there was another incident. Kier drove out one last time to calm the situation. He was lured to one of his own police checkpoints. The commander was curiously missing, and a member of the ruling party, a Croat named Gudel, blocked his way.
Nih je zaustavljao, niti pokušao zaustaviti, nego je ispalio cijeli šanžer na auto. Suprug moj je dobio 16 metaka. To mu je bila nagrada za sve mjesece rada i zalaganja. Je bio u rezervnom sastavu policije i da bude apsurd veći, par dana prije je došao kod Josipa po naoružanje i Josip je zadužio mu kalašnjikov. I sa tim kalašnjikovim ga je ubio.
Two days later, a column of tanks, 20 miles long, set off from Belgrade to the Croat border. They flew the Yugoslav flag, but increasingly, this was the army of the Serb president, Milosevic. They claimed they were neutral peacekeepers and that the Serbs in the Croatian countryside needed their protection. The Serb media backed them up.